I just first want to say thank you for allowing me to share. I'm already going to get emotional, but this is just a small picture of God's saving grace in my life. I really don't deserve any of this. Psalm 105:1 says, "Give thanks to the Lord and proclaim his greatness. Let the whole world know what he has done." Growing up, my parents took us to church on and off, and at 14, I started using drugs and alcohol, and at 15, I was a runaway. I lived a very reckless lifestyle, very dangerous and very destructive. I dropped out of high school, and drugs and alcohol became my desires and my escape from everything. Because of my addictions to drugs and alcohol, I've experienced sexual abuse, physical abuse. I've had 2 miscarriages and 2 abortions. I've caused hurt and grief to a lot of loved ones. I have 3 daughters, 19, 12, and 5. And because of my addictions, I was involved with DHS for many years. I've been through 8 treatment programs. I lost legal custody of my 2 older girls. My mom adopted them in 2010. And my life became an even more of a train wreck. My lifestyle with drugs and alcohol got worse and even more dangerous. I was in and out of jail. I was homeless. I was doing what I had to survive and to support my addiction. I met my husband in 2012, and we were both lost souls in active addiction. I ended up in jail once again. And by the grace of God, they offered me treatment once again. After a few months in jail, I was able to go to the Bridges of Iowa program. At this point, I was ready for a serious change. It's now 2013, and I met Lori Tashner. She was doing women's Bible studies every week at Bridges. And she asked me if I had a personal relationship with Jesus. And if I died tonight, would I be sure that I was going to heaven? And I knew that I had done so many bad things, and I lived such a godless lifestyle that I wanted to know what I had to do to be saved. Lori went through a salvation Bible study with me and took me through God's word. That's when I understood the gospel. I understood that Jesus died for my sin. He was buried and rose again, and I realized that I needed to repent and put my trust in Jesus as my personal Savior, and that's what I did. In October of 2013, I cried out to the Lord, I repented of my sins, and I placed my trust in Jesus Christ. I got baptized here at Saylorville Church, and in 2014, I was halfway through the Bridges of Iowa program. And it had been some months since I had talked to or even seen Adam. We had gotten in contact, and he told me that he was clean and doing well. It didn't take long for me to realize that he was still using, but I thought that I could help him. Surely if I can get clean and turn my life to the Lord, Adam could too. But I now know that only God can truly save. I ended up falling away from church. I thankfully was able to graduate the Bridges program at 7 months pregnant with our daughter, Ella. Adam and I got married, bringing a lot of baggage into the marriage. We drank together, and that turned real bad real quick for me. I was back into full-blown alcoholism. I was hiding drinking. I was lying, which caused a lot of problems between Adam and I. My life was out of control again. Ella's only about 2 years old, and both of her parents are lost, and my drinking is causing so much destruction, and Adam so much anger. I was dying on the inside, and our marriage was about to be over. I reached out to Pastor Chuck and Lori, because she never gave up on me, I knew that I could call her. And Adam was willing to do some sort of counseling, so Pastor Chuck is who I called. Him and Lori both walked alongside of me in the Bridges program, and they always pointed me to Christ. Pastor Chuck was at our house the next couple of days, going through scripture with Adam and I, and the salvation study with Adam. But at this time, I was still not sober-minded. I was highly medicated on prescriptions, and on top of the drinking, I started questioning my salvation. But Pastor Chuck and Lori, they pointed me to the Word of God, and His Word of Truth showed me that I had been saved. And that while others were never getting caught, I kept getting caught in my sins. I knew God was chastening me back to Him. God is so merciful and forgiving. And that takes me to Philippians 1:6. And I am certain that God, who began the good work within you, will continue His work until it is finished on the day when Christ Jesus returns. But I had to experience a little more darkness. I went to jail once again for my drinking. I was living in a hotel room for about a week because I couldn't go home. And with only God and myself, I was on my knees crying out to the Lord again for forgiveness and to change me. I called Lori and I told her I needed help. And shortly after that, I started counseling with her and Pastor Kurt. I also started going through the Word of God every day with Lori for a year. And I've continued to meet with Lori every week. God has removed the alcohol. He's removed the drugs. He's removed the prescription medications. God's Word is my daily medication. I am now memorizing scripture. Adam and I are members, and we serve here at Saylorville Church. I continue to be discipled, and I now disciple my children, other women. My relationships with Adam and our blended family of five children and my family have changed dramatically. With the help of God, I've grown closer to each and every one of them. I work part-time here at church, which I'm very grateful for. Adam and I are co-leaders in our small group, and we have become a part of a ministry called GCR, Gospel-Centered Recovery, because I truly believe that God has allowed me to go through all this darkness to give Him all the glory and to help others living in darkness. I truly believe that recovery without Christ is a dead-end road. And because of God's Word, church, and discipleship, this has been the best almost 2 years in April that I've ever had clean and sober. I have a desire and an honor to serve the Lord. And I want to share Romans 13:11-14. This is all the more urgent, for you know how late it is. Time is running out. Wake up, for our salvation is nearer now than when we first believed. The night is almost gone. The day of salvation will soon be here. So remove your dark deeds like dirty clothes and put on the shining armor of right living. Because we belong to the day, we must live decent lives for all to see. Don't participate in the darkness of wild parties and drunkenness or sexual promiscuity and immoral living or quarreling or jealousy. Instead, clothe yourself with the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ, and don't let yourself think about ways to indulge your evil desires. I give all the glory to God for His saving grace in my life. And I thank you very much.